The next afternoon, they reach the village of the Hawks. Where is the house of the chief? Over there, right there, that's their house, the two hawk chiefs, Big Blue Hawk and Little Sparrow Hawk. They are the chiefs of this place. Hawk chief, hawk chief. Well, what do you want? Why do you make so much noise? The door's on the east side.
Don't speak that way, said Blue Hawk to Sparrow Hawk. You're too rough. Haven't you got any manners? How'd you know but that these people are important people come to visit us, and you treat them rough like that? Come in, come in. Go around. You people aren't used to our country. We don't come and go out through the smoke hole here. We have a door. Go right around the east side. Come right in. But the Sparrow Hawk had already flown out. He went out through his own door. He had a hole in the side of the wall, by the side of the big door. A door all for himself, just his size. He went out. He was mad. He flew out into the night.
Come right in, said Blue Hawk. They went in, Bear and Antelope, stooping under the lintel of the doorway, and Fox stooping too. They all sat around the fire, and Antelope was unpacking the baby quail. All the hawk people came in one by one and sat on their heels around the wall. Then Blue Hawk Chief spoke.
You are welcome here. You've come a long way. You are welcome.
We didn't know where the door was. Our people have the door on the side. Maybe your people have the smoke hole for a door. That's a good way, too. But somebody spoke about another door.
Oh, that's my older brother. That's Sparrow Hawk. Don't pay any attention to him. He is a bad one. He is a mean one. That's his door there. You can see that little door there? You see it? Well, that's his door. Can't come in through the main door like everyone else. Must have his own little door.
He never grew up. I don't know why. Some people say it's because he had the ha-has when he was a little boy. They say it keeps him from growing up properly. I don't know. It's possible. I remember he used to cry and yowl and stomp his foot and say, I don't want to. I don't want to. I don't want to. Just like that. Seems that's the way they sing when they've got the bad case of the ha-has. Anyway, he never grew up, stayed small and mean. But here he comes, I hear him, listen. And out of the night they heard his song, coming nearer and nearer. Ya, ya, henna, ya, ya, henna. They all looked toward the small hole by the side of the main door. Sparrow Hawk flew in, making a zigzag and a loop, and then stood above their heads, flapping his wings. Then he alighted in the cleared space in the front of the fire and said,
Hello.
Hello yourself, said Fox Boy, and he roared with laughter. I want to play with that little boy. I like him. Everybody roared with laughter. Sparrow Hawk cried, All right, I'll play with you. Come on.
Watch out, boy, watch out. He is hard to handle. He is spoiled. But if you want to keep him for a pet, you can have him. We won't miss him.
The fox boy then grabbed the sparrow hawk, and they had a lively tussle on the floor, almost rolled into the fire. Fox gave a yell and let the hawk loose. The hawk had bitten him on the thumb. Fox cried, I don't want him for a pet. You can keep him. The sparrow hawk flew out through his own little door, and they could hear his war song diminishing in the night. Fox Boy was nursing his thumb. All the hawk people were rocking with laughter. Blue Hawk was laughing, too. He cried, Let him go. You are not losing much of a pet. I sort of thought you couldn't handle him. He may be small, but he is hard to handle. Now the hawk people were settling for the night, choosing places for themselves here and there around the wall of the house. Bear picked up his pack and started for the door. "Where are you going?" asked the Blue Hawk chief. "Oh, I'm going out to look for a place for us to sleep."
"No, you don't have to do that. Sleep right here with us. Plenty of room. Make your bed here inside, anywhere. I see you have a rabbit skin blanket. How do you make those blankets?"
"Oh, it's easy," said Antelope. "It's not much of a trial. It only takes patience and a lot of rabbits. About 200 rabbits. Cut the skins in long strips, then twist them. That makes the fur stick out. Then weave the strips together. That's all."
"Well, well," said Blue Hawk Chief, "you are a clever people."
"And I help my mother twist the strings," said Fox Boy proudly.
"Well, well, you did. And did you catch the rabbits too?"
"Nope," said Fox. "They won't keep still."
All the hawks roared with laughter, and Fox Boy laughed with everybody. And now they were settling themselves for the night. Blue Hawk called, "Fire tender, fire tender, where are you? Poke that fire, put some twigs to burn, and give us light to make our beds."